Anna Jones, this is 25 years ago. I don't remember walking on the air.
Yeah.
Isn't that lovely, walking in the air? Beautiful from the snowman. I always think about that for Christmas, really.
Yeah.
It wasn't actually a Christmas number one, but that's when we think about that, I think. Beautiful. So I guess that it makes sense that he's hoping to hit the top of the festive charts with his new protege, simply known as Isabel. Her name's Isabel Suckling, but we have to just call her Isabel.
I'm not surprised with a surname like
it's a name you drop in showbiz, yeah. Isn't it? Yeah, it is. She's only 12, and she's the world's first choir girl to sign a record deal, and she actually put pen to paper in a London iPod yesterday, so it's signing in the air. You can see where they were going with that, can't you, with the publicity. And their first single is going to be a cover of Michael Jackson's You Are Not Alone. And after, over the last few years, of course, it's always been the X Factor winner that's tried to kind of slam dunk that number one. So this is what this year's X Factor winner, if I could even speak, has to contend with. Have a look.
You are not alone, for I am here with you. Though we're far apart, you're always in my heart.
Aw, she's a pretty little
thing. Sounds beautiful. And of course, unlike poor old Alid, who kind of had a wobble in his career, if we can put it that way, her voice broke. Her voice won't break.
Exactly.
She can go
She'll
on
carry
forever.
On.
Yeah. She can be brilliant.
The record company behind Lady Gaga, she of the Meat Hat, Elton John and the Rolling Stones has signed their youngest ever solo classical artist. And we have her in the studio this morning. Her name is Isabel Suckling. With all that talk of meat, that's a particularly appropriate name this morning. And Isabel has broken an almost exclusively male singing tradition. She's becoming the first choir girl to be signed by Decca Records. But it doesn't stop there. Beside her is her manager. Not only her manager, her mentor, who people will recognise as Mr. Alid Jones. Very good to see you.
Nice to see you.
How are you? So you are a poacher turned gamekeeper. Oh,
get out of it.
I
the
suppose.
Choir boys had it too good for too long. So it's time for the choir girl. I don't want you to think I'm sitting in an office managing her. I'm just sort of offering advice, you know.
And mentoring.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that Simon Cowell way.
Well, I'm going to pull my trousers up a little bit higher then.
Alid, when it happened for you, Isabel is 12 years of age, Isabel, you are?
Yeah.
How old were you, Alid, when it happened for
about
you?
About 12 years old as well.
Yeah. Will Isabel have to go through what you have to go through? Would her voice break the way you had to wait for that coming, hadn't you?
I didn't come here for counselling.
Yes.
No, it won't, thankfully.
It won't.
No. But, you know, I had a good innings. I sang till I was 16. With Isabel, her voice will just get more and more mature. Mm-hmm. So, no, she'll carry on singing.
And Isabel, what is this like? Is this a big responsibility on your shoulders? Very shortly we're going to hear exactly what you sound like.
Oh, well, it's really amazing. I've never done anything like this before, and to have Alid as my mentor is pretty cool.
Not very cool, just pretty cool.
Yes.
How did you come to Alid's attention and to Decca Records' attention?
Well, I did an audition for them. They were looking for a choir girl, and they came up and filmed an audition, and I went and did another one in London, and that's how they found me.
Well, if you watch this big screen behind you here, you will see what they saw in you, and we'll hear it as well. Here we go. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful way to ease us into the morning. What were you singing there?
Well, two of my songs, P.A. Zoo and Ecce Homo.
And that was in St. Bartholomew's,
yeah, in London. Yeah.
In London, which reminded me of your wedding day, Charlotte.
I was thinking that. We had a choir boy singing P.A. Zoo on our wedding day, and I just... I would have had, if I'd known that there were choir girls available, of course I would have done. But it's just so beautiful. I mean, that was just... amazing. And what was it like for you when you sort of started to realise that you could sing and people, I guess, were saying you're really good at singing?
Well, I was about six, and my piano teacher suggested that I join the choir. And then, no, I've never done singing before that. And then my singing teacher said, wow, you really have got a special voice. So after that, it was just simple.
Inevitably, yeah. People are going to say, of course, you've got the new Charlotte Church here, you've got the new Catherine Jenkins. What have you got?
No, you haven't. You've got a 12-year-old with an amazing voice, you know, no comparisons. What's brilliant about Isabel is that you've just heard in that clip, she's singing things like Pia Jesu, which is, you know, core classic, classical piece of music, sacred piece of music, and also the theme from, you know, Mr. Bean. So you've got everything on the album, which is, you know, why pigeonhole yourself, really? So she's sing anything she wants.
I will predict now that in 10 years' time, on some TV show, somebody will be playing this clip where I say, when I'm talking to you as a 12-year-old and predicting that when you're 21 years of age, you will be a massive star in the country. Do you think that's fair enough?
Absolutely, Alan? And I've told her never to wear a meat suit.
Yeah, don't go down that route.
And
ever.
Isabel, when you're away, I mean, are you strictly classical, or what is the music that you like?
I sing both classical and pop. I play guitar as well, and so I write my own music and play that. But I sing pop as well as classical, which is really fun because I get to show people the other side of my voice.
Sure. And have you two sung together? Do you plan to sing
together? Yeah, we've got a duet on the album, but it's not me as a man, it's actually me as a young boy. How freaky is that now? Everyone's going, well, I've had a drink at this time in the morning.
Well, it's better than you as a woman. I thought that's what you were going to tell
that's
me.
That's coming on the next album. I'm so, really committed.
So they've revisited your vaults and your archive tapes, yeah?
I've got an album that I recorded as a boy that no one's ever heard. It's coming out next year, folk songs. But we gave one of the tracks for Isabel, and it's really strange because our voices really, really blend together beautifully.
It's absolutely fantastic what they can do with technology nowadays. Isabel Suckling, you heard it here first, you saw her here first. Every success to you, and thank you very much indeed for coming in today and lending a bit of class to the occasion. Look at the way she's dressed today. You see, that's very good. Do you know Charlotte is a bishop's daughter?
Are you really?
My father wasn't actually a bishop. He was a canon, though. Yeah.
Yes.
So I used to be one of the girls at the altar helping out. But I was never a choir girl. I would have loved to have been, though.
There you are.
I'm glad I turned up just for that.
That's a subject for the next Songs of Praise, Alan.
Absolutely,
that's a story there. Thank you very much indeed, Alan Jones and Isabel Suckling. Thank you. Charlotte, email.